Hi, it's Dr. Lee, and thank you for joining me. This prayer will be called Walking in Obedience. Walking in Obedience. And it comes from Deuteronomy 5:33. And I'm reading from the NIV. Walk in obedience to all that the Lord your God has commanded you, so that you may live and prosper and prolong your days in the land that you will possess. And I'm speaking on obedience because just me, I think a lot of people don't either take being obedient seriously, like, you know, being obedient to God's word, even though, you know, may say, oh, I love the Lord and I have faith and I pray. But the key to it all is being obedient. God wants us to be obedient. He already loves us, but he wants us to be obedient to his word. And it's just like any other thing that has instructions. And it's like the Bible's our instructions. And if any other thing you have, like if you have a hair dryer, and some people call them blow dryers, but a hair dryer, and you wash your hair, and it tells you on it, do not, you know, put it by water. Do not dry your hair in the bathtub, you know? It's a reason. And so with everything like that, it is a reason. It's precaution, safety. But with the Bible, we kind of like, you know, we believe in it, but we kind of like, you know, we're still going to do our own thing because it feels good to our flesh. So we're still going to get in the bathtub with, you know, with the blow dryer, with the hair dryer. And we've done it like the last 30 years and nothing happened. Then one day, it drops into the water and it fry you, you know? And so, I mean, maybe that's not the best example, but I'm just trying to break it down so you can understand why you should work on your obedience. I'm working on my obedience, so I just want to encourage you to work on your obedience and encourage you to pray more and, of course, read your Bible. And so in order to be obedient, you have to read your Bible. And when you pray, stand on scripture. Bring it back to God. You know, tell, you know, God, say, I'm standing on your word. And, you know, God already know his word, but it's nothing like standing on it. Say, God, I'm coming to you with what you put in the Bible for us to know. And so that's what I'm doing here. And my whole goal is to inspire, encourage whoever I can, you know. So that's what I'm doing. And, of course, pray more myself. So I'm just sharing some of my prayers with you. And as always, you can close your eyes and pray with me, or just touch and agree, watch me, or, you know, however you pray, or you can repeat the prayer, you know, whatever. The whole goal is just to, just for you to see someone else like you praying, just your regular person that loves the Lord, and I mean, no more, no less, and just want to grow in God and be, you know, as obedient as I can be, and with the help of the Holy Spirit, and just continue to grow and grow and grow and just grow closer and closer to the Lord. So, okay, so here is the prayer, walking in obedience. I'm gonna bow my head. Father, I come to you standing on Deuteronomy 5:33. Your word tells us to walk in obedience and all that you have commanded, so that we may live and prosper and prolong our days in the land that we will possess. So, Father, I ask that your Holy Spirit guide me daily, enabling me to walk in obedience to your word. May my obedience be a light and a drawing mechanism for your heavenly kingdom to all the people you have ordained to receive your message through me. Father, I love you, and I thank you for hearing my prayer. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. And so, that's it. So, just grow in walking in obedience. Pray more, pray more, pray more. And as always, just in case you don't have a relationship with Jesus Christ and you happen to just kind of stumble across this video, all you have to do, if you want to scroll, find out more about the Lord, and turn your life over to God, all you have to do is just accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. And what you need to do is just say, Father, I repent. I believe your son rose in 3 days. You know, I mean, however you want to say it. God knows your heart. That's what's most important. And accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. And trust me, he will put you on the path. He'll put the right resources, the right people, the right videos, the right audio, just, I mean, books. It just to help you on this journey. And so, as always, I'm Dr. Lee, and thank you for watching. And remember to pray. Pray more. If you've been praying once a day, aim at twice a day. If it's 2 minutes, aim at 4 minutes. However much you pray, pray more. Pray more than just, you know, some people pray when they start their morning. Some people pray when they may eat or when they go to bed. Throw a prayer, you know, just whenever you can while you're driving in your car. You know, ask God to guide you, to be with you. It's just that easy. You don't have to be long prayers. All God wants you to do is communicate with him because he loves you. And so, anyhow, with all that, remember to walk in obedience, read your Bible, and pray. I'm Dr. Lee, and as always, let go, let God, and keep it moving. Take care.